need to make some room here. Interesting. Now, frequent viewers of the channel might have seen, noticed, and heard me talk about Maston sprays for, well, forever. Because I've been using them for the better part of God knows how many years now on tutorials and just in general finishing things. And there's a good few reasons for doing so, which I'm going to talk about fairly soon. But this is... this is pretty crazy because Maston reached out to me on Instagram, thanking me for tagging them in a lot of posts and wondering if I would want them to send me some stuff. So they did. And I'm not usually one for doing unboxing videos on my channel. It happens from time to time, but I haven't done any in a very long time. Stands to reason then that I should actually do this now. But hey, let's have a look at some of the cool, wonderful things that Maston have sent me, shall we? I have a feeling I'm gonna run out of real estate on my table here, but hey, let's go for it nonetheless. Some of the products that I do use quite a lot are the Maston 1 varnishes or gloss lacquers. And I got, seems like, 6 cans of the Maston 1 gloss lacquer here. And the reason why I use this particular lacquer, well, there's actually many reasons for it. One, this reason goes for all Maston cans, really, is the fact that it has an adjustable fan. So I can have a fan that goes like that or like that. And everything goes on super smooth and a very consistent layer, which makes my life so much easier. Also, what makes things easier, it's this stuff is touch dry in 5 minutes and it hardens within 24 hours. And it's actually pretty damn hard. I don't like to put on massive, massive amounts of lacquer or clear coat, anything, no type of finish. I don't want too much stuff to go on because I don't want to inhibit the wood itself. I want the wood to breathe and I want it to be sort of thin enough but hard and durable. So this acrylic based clear coat is by far the simplest solution I've found, especially for someone like me who doesn't have a spray gun and a massive spray booth meant for guitar building. So yeah, this has been a lifesaver. So 6 cans of Maston high gloss lacquer. this is pretty ridiculous. Then I have another box or another bit, 6-pack of Maston lacquer satin. Oh, this is awesome. Great, because I actually have use for this for an upcoming build. I like to go for satin instead of matte most times because I just feel like, well, I just like it a little bit more for the look, for the feel. It feels nicer. Matte has a tendency of showing a lot of scratches and also it becomes, well, not matte after a very, very quick episode. Hold on. Oh, holy crap. The label on the Maston 1 gloss is gloss. And the label on the satin is satin. Sure, you could already, like, if you're just picking this up from the shelf, you can already tell from the... You could already tell from, you know, the cap that this is gloss and this one's satin, but the fact that already by feel, they feel different. It's a very nice touch. Got 6 of these, and I'm starting to run out of space here. Let's see what else we got. I can see some blacks. So we got Maston 1 Satin Black. Great. Probably gonna find good use for that. There's always good use for blacks. So I've got 3 of those. Cool, I see some white. So once again, Maston Satin Whites. A good few of those. 3 of those as well. The same? Yep, they're the same. Awesome. What's this? Wood stain. What is this? Maston wood stain. So it's not... Okay. So once again, touch dry in 5 minutes. Wipe off after 5 minutes. Overpaint with lacquer. So I guess this is just a... It's not very hard stuff. So, yeah. I guess this is just a sort of, like, stain. I look forward to actually checking that out. That looks interesting. I've never seen this product before. So, I'll do some tests. We'll see how things go. What is this? Oh! Candy effect. Tangerine. What is this? Translucent glossy finish. 3 layers. 3 minutes between layers. 20 minutes touch dry. 24 hours full hardness. Solvent based acryl, which is exactly what I want. So it's fast drying translucent coating. Mimics the look of anodized aluminum. Quick application process. The color depth can be intensified by spraying more layers. That's gonna be cool. This is gonna be really cool. And I can see that there's another one. So it's candy red. Apple red. Oh my goodness. I've been wanting some candy colors for a very long time, but I didn't know that Maston had these, so that's really cool. Oh, I'm gonna have a blast with these two, for sure. Let's see, what else do we have? We do have some matte lacquer. Sweet. Okay, so now I'm covering the full spectrum. So I got the stuff that I usually use, gloss, satin, and now I got matte. In case somebody would want matte colors, now I have matte as well. That's pretty cool. Okay, sweet. And last but not least, yep, that is the last can. We have rust effect. Okay. What is this? Smooth surface. Rough surface. Oh, okay. So the closer you are, the smoother your surface is going to be. The further you are, the rougher it's going to be. Full hardness. Not quite as hard as the Maston 1 lacquers we have here. The spectrum is... from like 1 to 5, sorry. So these are 4s. This is a 3. The wood stain is a 1. Normal paint goes to about 4 as well. The Maston 1 generally goes to 4. Rust effect. Okay, cool. If I can find an application for this, this will be a cool thing to try. Sweet. Okay. Well, we got a lot of things to try out, and I'm looking forward to, well, all of them, in a way, sure. But for sure, the lacquers are something that I use for, well, all projects where I need to put on clear coat. So those are definitely gonna get used. Black is next up. That's something that I get asked quite a lot to do. White, for sure, definitely gonna be, at the very least, a very good base coat for stuff. Wood stain, looking forward to trying that out and seeing what it is. Because I've never seen it before. The rust effect. I know that Maston has a lot of effect type things. Rust, concrete, and stuff like that. And stone. So this will be interesting to try. But what I am definitely most excited for is the candy effect stuff. So I'm going to be trying these out and seeing what we get. So I can't wait to actually try out some of the newer products. And in general, just get very good use out of all my new masks and sprays. I must say that this video is not a paid advertisement of any sort. I've always used masks and sprays and I love them. And Maston just sent all this stuff to me. And it's crazy. Thank you so much. And please, if you can find them, go check out Maston Sprays, Maston OY. And I'm gonna be filming a lot of videos with these for sure. And we'll go over what we can do with the candy colors and some of the more experimental stuff with the rust and the wood stain. So stay tuned for that for sure. Okay, so at the spray room of Vuokravestas, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be spraying the pick guard black, then we're gonna do the body and the neck we're gonna do with satin. Maston 1, I'm gonna be, in general, just using Maston 1 rattle cans. I'm gonna be mixing these cans up, and then I'll see you in the spray booth.
I don't know how much you can see or how focused it is, but hopefully we get a good enough shot for you. So, just making sure that there's no excess dust on the body here. And then, we're gonna be starting off doing the sides, then the back, and then the front. And following the curve, keeping about 15 centimeters away from the actual paintable surface. So, there we go. And I'm following the curve of the body as I go. Then when I'm going over, I'm basically gonna have the first layer, and then the next pass is gonna go half on top of the previous pass. All right, so that's the body done. And the first layer of it, we're gonna do, yeah. So this session, we're gonna do three layers of this. The first coat is rather very, very light, but the next couple of coats, they're gonna go on a bit thicker.
All right, so this is gonna dry up nice. We're gonna put more, probably tomorrow. And there's still a little bit to go on this one. I think one more layer should about do it. Yeah, thank you for watching this video. Click like, subscribe, and hey, let me know in the comments, what do you want to see? Now that I have a nice kind of new arsenal of things to play around with, what do you want to see me paint? What kind of finishes would you want to see me do with these or other Maston colors that I might not have here? Comment down below. Let me know. It would be cool to find out.